Hi, everybody. Okay. Welcome to the fold. I have total bedhead right now. I just noticed. How's everybody doing? I'm gonna let you guys all come on. I'm checking out my Twitter to see if anybody has any questions. I wanted to say thank you, as usual. Thanks for joining me today. It's a very exciting day. I don't know if you guys have seen, but just like a few minutes ago, really, I announced with Greenpeace that I am their first Antarctic ambassador and that I'm going to be going to Antarctica with Greenpeace on their boat, the Arctic Sunrise, although I think it might be the Antarctic Sunrise. In like less than 3 weeks. So I'm going to become an actual explorer for the first time in my life, which is pretty exciting. Get to visit the penguins and the whales and the glaciers, and I mean, it's like a complete and utter dream come true. Cannot wait. Yeah, I wanted to talk about it. I'm sorry that I've been gone for 3 weeks. I mean, it was Christmas and, a lot's been happening, and then I had a few things to go to last week. So I'm sorry that I was missing, but I'm really happy to be here today. So I guess, I just wanted to kind of like say hi, really, and answer any questions that's going on. I know Places 1989 said, now that you're an Antarctic ambassador, what are you looking forward to experiencing? One of the things that I'm really looking forward to experiencing is the prospect of going to a place untouched or largely untouched by human beings, to go somewhere that's so dominated by nature and so vast and wild, and to just observe and to try and make as little impact as I can. I think it's going to be quite life-changing in that, the awe of a place like this, somewhere that is so sort of alien to us and daily life. Like, there's no Starbucks in Antarctica, thank goodness. It's going to be a completely new experience to be somewhere so far from civilization. And we're going to some very remote areas as well, so we can observe wildlife. And I will be documenting it and sharing it with you, so you can join in the experience. And we're going to do quite an intimate documentary as well. I want to share with you the whole experience. I'm not naturally an explorer. I have a feeling I'm going to be seasick at some point. But I just want to take you with us, so it's going to be pretty, pretty intimate, and I think potentially quite sad as well, because part of the reason that we're going down there is because the area of ocean down there, it's ungoverned and it's unprotected, and so there's all kinds of stuff happening down there, which I'll tell you more about in the future. But there's a lot of things happening down there, which it's just not fair to the environment. And so we're going to be learning about that and seeing it firsthand, and I know that's not going to be easy. But the main thing to the main point of this part of the trip is just to see the wildlife. So yeah, I think it's going to be pretty incredible. Looking at some more questions. Some people are asking when the next album is coming. It's going to be coming probably like spring. Spring. There'll be more music coming soon, but yeah, the actual album will be coming out in the spring. How is it to work with Mr. Dan Fogler? Is he as funny a guy as he seems? That is Jimmy Ferris. Yes, he is as funny a guy as he seems, and he's a lovely human being and wonderful, and I adore him. What is that? Oh, that's. Sorry, strange noise is happening. Am I gonna discuss Women Who Run With the Wolves again? I could. I'd like to discuss Women Who Run With the Wolves every time I talk on one of these, but I didn't have something prepared for today. I mainly just wanted to come and say hi. Will my trip to Antarctica inspire some new music? Yes, I am pretty sure it will. Do you guys have some more questions for me? I'm waiting. Am I having fun on this trip that I'm on? Yeah. Yes, I am having fun on the trip that I'm on. I am having a very good time. I am very happy at the moment. That's a very nice question. How does it feel to inspire so many people all over the world with your music, your impersonations, and being a goodwill ambassador for the IUCN? Isn't it overwhelming? Well, I just feel grateful that, that I can make art and that people want to listen and watch. And I feel so honored to work with the IUCN and now to work with Greenpeace. And it's an amazing thing, I get to do extraordinary things. I get to help nature, but like all of us can, you guys inspire me all the time, and I just I'm grateful to be in a position where I can do what I love every day. I feel like yeah, like I won the lottery or something. What else? I keep missing your questions, I'm sorry. What are your thoughts on consuming meat? That's interesting. I try to eat very little meat, and I try to be aware of where it's coming from and the fact that it's an actual animal that I'm consuming. I think mindfulness with eating in general is really important because like if you think about it, like your body is this really amazing, complex organism, and eating is fueling it, right? So like everything that I put in my body, I try to imagine like, okay, is this actually gonna help? Is it gonna give me energy? Is it gonna help me feel healthier? And where animals come from, it really matters, like in terms of factory farmed animals are pumped full of antibiotics and they're kept in really bad and extreme conditions that is not healthy for anybody. And then you're like, you're taking that, and not only you're supporting the industry with your money, but you're also putting it into your body. So I try to think about that. Obviously, I'm not perfect, and I eat stuff where I'm like, oof, that was a mistake afterwards. But I think just trying to like be aware of what you're doing, what you're putting into your body is, it's a great step, you know, and not judging yourself, but just trying to listen, ask questions. And there are so many meals that you can make that don't require an animal's life to be taken, that have protein and are delicious, and there's lots of recipes and books out there that support that. So if you can just like reduce your consumption, then you're doing something good. How was my experience at the Critics' Choice Awards? That was really fun. It was really, yeah, it was fun. It's fun to get to be in a room with a bunch of artists that you admire, and get to talk to people and you know, tell them that their work inspires you. And people are really lovely and really open and really happy to talk. And you know, little Brooklyn Prince is just like the cutest little being, and she's whispered some words into my ear that I'm never gonna forget. She's so wise. Yeah, it was a good time. Well, I might just pop off now. Because, yeah. Because I gotta go do some stuff. I gotta go pack up. But anyway, I just wanted to say hi, and I'm really excited to talk more about my adventure with Greenpeace in the coming weeks. And I'll share more about the music, and I'm really just grateful for you guys. Should we do like a quick meditation before we go? Do you want to like take a second and just breathe with me before we get off? Can we do that? Just to like either say goodnight if this is the end of your night, or to start your day, or to just take a moment in the middle of the day just for a little bit of peace. Okay, so let's just I'm seeing people protesting. You don't have to do it. This is a live stream. I can't see what you're doing. All right, so let's just take a few breaths and close your eyes. And just observe your breathing. Observe whatever you are sitting on in this moment. If you place your hands on your knees and feel your knees underneath your hands, whatever is going on in your life right now, whether you are having the best day of your life or the worst. Life is always changing, it's always moving and shifting, and the one truly consistent thing is your breathing, just being here in the present moment. Any time of the day, you can just stop and find a little bit of stillness. Any point, you can return to your breath. And I know that might sound hippy dippy, but it does help in this crazy world that's moving so fast. Just pause for a minute and observe where you are, and don't worry about anything. You don't need to judge it. Just be with whatever you're feeling. I wish you such a beautiful day, and yeah, I wish you a lot of joy. Have a beautiful one.